Hello, good morning,
and welcome to today's lesson. My name is Vincent. I'm here to take you through mathematics class 5. And today we are starting a new topic, decimals. And before that, I just want to remind you about decimals. Decimals is a number, just like a fraction. A decimal is another number that can be expressed instead of a fraction. And in this case, in decimals, we are using a dot, a point. Now, for example, if you have a number like, remember, I said that decimal is derived from a fraction. For example, this is a fraction. Then, sometimes in back in class 4, you are going to convert this one into a decimal. How did you do this? You only have 1 0 here, you'll make this one jump, then this one will become 0.1. This is a 10, it's called a 10. So this one is called a 10. Then again, you have like 1 over 100. The point is here at this time, so we have to make two jumps because of the two zeros. One, the point is here, again another jump, the second jump, the point is here. So it's going to be 0.01. This is 100. 100, then you add THS. TH. 100. 100. Now, today, I'm going to take you through the following work. First of all, we'll start with the place value of decimals. You can have a number like this one, 51.6. 51.6 is a number, it's a decimal number. Because of these points, this one is a decimal number, this one. This one's a decimal number because of this point. So we can conclude, if we have to write this one in this using place value of numbers, this is what we are going to do. We come up with a very simple table. This one here is a table. We have a table here. We have a table. This is the table. And of course we have the number here. So we have the number. Then we have place values. Now, we start with thousands. We have our place. Here we are having thousands. We have hundreds, tens, we have ones, then here this thick line means a decimal, this one means decimal, then after that we have tens. We have tens with the TH. Tenths with the TH, and then we are having hundreds, with TH, like this one here. After the point, we are starting with tenths. We don't have ones. We only have, after the point, we start with tenths, hundreds, thousands. You write thousand, then you add TH, S, like that. Then from there now, we can come up with the numbers that are to be added into this table. For example, we have the number like, we have this number, for example, I have this number 56.1. Now, 56.1, if it is to be filled in this table, first of all, you note where the point is. Note where the point is. The point is here. So immediately after the point, you write 1. The point is here. So write 1 here. Then the rest of the numbers, you write 6 here, then 5 here. So the first thing, you note where the point is. The point is here. So immediately after the point 1, then you write, this is the point 1 is there. Then 6 before the point. Then from there, we move to 102.001. And when you go to the table filling it, it's very simple. After the point, we have 2 zeros, then 1. Go there. After that, this is the point. We have 0, then 0, then 1. And you fill 001. Then before the point, this is the point. To this side, you start with the 2, 0, then 1. So you have 2. You have 2 here. 0, then 1. Like that. So if you have any other numbers to the lower end, you have to fill them the way I've just shown you. I hope, Lala, you are following what we are doing up to that point. Now, the third example, which is the last one, you have this number, 0.05. I told you the first thing, identify where the point is, the thick line, that's where the point is. Therefore, you have zero, up that point, you have 0, then 5, 0, then 5. Then before the point, you have the other 0. So you are done, 0.05. So up to that point, I hope you'll be able, or you'll be set to work out all those questions the way they are to be done. Now, we are moving on to something different, but not such different, because you had done this one in class 4. We are moving to changing fractions into decimals. Remember, this is what you did in your previous class. Changing fractions into decimals. Remember when I started this lesson, I showed you this one. Now, I'm going to give you 2 more examples. Then from there, you'll be set to go. Now, the first example is this. The first example is 52 over 1,000. Look at here what we are supposed to do. In the lower end, just count the number of zeros. How many are there? 1, 2, 3. The number of zeros will determine the number of jumps we are going to make from the right to the left. Look, at this time the point is here. So we are making 3 jumps because of the number of zeros. So 1, 2, 3. Where we finish our jumps, that is where the point will be. So this curve here that has nothing, replace that space with 0. Then after the point, write another 0 to the other side. So come and write this one as our answer. Our answer is going to be 0.052. Now you have changed that one into a decimal. This fraction, 52 over 1,000, changed into a fraction to be 0.052. The next example, which is also very simple, is this. 352 over 1000. Okay? We do the same thing we did up here. The point is at the end of this number. So how many jumps are we going to make? The number of jumps will depend on the zeros we are having. 1, 2, 3. So 3 jumps. So start. 1, 2, 3. So after finishing our jumps, that is where our point will be. Then add the zero to the other side. So our answer is going to be 0.352. 0.352. Now, I'm going to add you a bonus example. A bonus example is this one. A bonus example is 9 over 10. Now, how many zeros are you seeing? 1. So, 1 jump. The point is here. Make a single jump. 1. The point will be there after finishing your 1 jump. Then add a 0. So, our answer is 0.9. So, up to that point, I think and I believe that you are able to work out all the questions that I'll be sending to you later in the day. Otherwise, have a good day. Thank you.